You may have noticed that I really like structural mechanics. There's no better way to learn structural mechanics than through using your Mola kits. But you may have seen my previous videos where I've gone through the different Mola kits that Mola has available to you. Even showing some of my kids the benefits of teaching structural mechanics in this way. They actually love playing with it, and it's a really good way to show how structural mechanics actually works in a real sense, as opposed to just playing around with numbers. But they've actually come up with a brand new kit, and they've actually currently got a Kickstarter for this Mola Kit 4. This Mola Kit 4 is all about shell structures, arches. They're actually running a Kickstarter, so if you haven't picked up one before, now is the best time ever, because on the Kickstarter they've got these amazing discounts. It's only for a short period of time. We'll break it down and have a look at it in a little bit more detail. But it comes with the standard Mola quality that we normally see. So we've got our board. We've actually got something interesting here, which we'll go into a little bit later. But if we have a look at the kit, there's a standard quality Mola that you're normally used to that can be used in both academic and just free play at home. This is what really makes this kit unique. We come up with these predefined papers to show the power of origami and how little folds can increase the stiffness of your structure. And you'd be surprised at how much a little fold can stiffen any element. So especially if you're doing cold form structures, just adding a little fold added so much rigidity. So I'll start off by looking at the powerful arch. Arch may look simple, but they're actually a lot more complex than you think, and you have some secondary actions that you may not think of. And with this kit and these curved springs, we can actually show the power of what an arch can do. And we'll just make it with a simple arch. So we just have two posts, two vertical upstands. We'll make it a little bit rigid with a fixed base. Now we need two connectors. And we've got a simple arch. Let's stabilize that a little bit better. Something you may notice, it's forming a specific shape. Now if we bring these two structure in, we can see something. Look what's happening here. You can see there's a curve happening in both these columns. So there's clearly an outwards force occurring, but we can deal with that outwards force with just a simple tie mechanism. So you can see, we can just put a simple tie member. We can make the arch even more efficient. So you can see there's a lot of quadrilateral force, but you can put a fair bit of force on the top there. If we take that spring out, apply that same force, you can see how much movement we're actually getting underneath even the lightest touch. But just with a simple tie member, we create a very rigid structure that's very stable. That's why you see in a lot of churches, they've got this tie arch that goes across, that ties it together, allowing you to stop those forces from moving out and combine them together. As both sides are balanced, it becomes a balanced system, even as you apply the forces to the top. Now let's get to something a little bit bigger. So we've got six curved arches to play with. So these triangle shapes help stiffen it up to get you more of a fixed base. Now I'm only fixing it in one direction as it stabilizes that way. As you can see, we're creating quite a rigid system here just through adding some cross braces and some rigid ties between them. We just want to stabilize it a little bit more. So we see here, we can make Brunelleschi's dome or a dome type structure that we see throughout Italy. It's a very simple shape, but it can take a lot of force. It has that same outwards force action that we saw in that simple dome, but what it's taken by is about this ring. As everything's balanced in action, as that ring tries to go bigger, it can't. So if we break the ring in one section, let's see what happens. And when we press on it, we can see the force is going out to cause a catastrophic collapse underneath very light touch. So Brunelleschi dome is one of those most famous structures that showed the true genius of some of the engineers back in the day. They were both architects and engineers making these amazing structures and how there would be these lateral forces that need to be resisted. Belt trusses around the middle of it to tie everything together to stop those outward forces. Those forces, as they try to move out, it doesn't distort, it just pushes out in those directions and it's resisted by the counterbalance of the forces in the other direction. But let's go through some of the origami and the benefits of the origami can have. This is something unique to the Mola 4 system. This is a little clip that allows you to connect to a bit of paper. So now we've got quite a rigid system through here. They come with this easy handy Allen key that we can use with the system. But if you do lose it, you can just use a standard little Allen key as well. But we'll use this system as it makes it a lot easier. So all I'm doing here is just unscrewing it. So we just put them all across each side. And we just do a couple of tests here. So we just do our flat paper system first. So you just screw it in to tighten it off. So now we've got our basic arch structure that we saw before. It's a little bit rigid, but as you can see, it's bowing out a little bit in the middle, but it's performing quite well. Let's apply a little bit of weight on it. Then we'll get a little bit more weight. I don't know how I'm going to balance it, but we'll see. See, it's kind of walking. Ah, You can see that they've got the collapse through there. Let's try again. We'll build it back up. See, the middle one failed. I wonder if we can do that with a little bit of a tension tie through the middle there. Try and load it up again. See, it's doing the same thing, but you can see that the failure is from a little bit of paper here now. See, now clearly it's the paper that's failing here now. Just by adding that simple tension tie, it's mean the structure won't fail, but we'll have a failure in the paper system. But there is a better way. Have you ever heard of origami structures or folded arches? Having simple folds can have a significant increase into the strength of your system. And we've got this simple structure that's got a simple geometric folds to it. These little folds have significant improvement strength from the system. We won't even need these tension ties. Now, the paper does come with these predefined folds, which makes it a lot easier. Now, before I actually test this, we'll actually show the true power of what the arch was doing before. That's the same bit of paper that we had before. Let's see how much we can actually load it up with. So it doesn't even nearly hold the same amount of weight. So just by folding it and forming that arch, we have significant improvements in strength. But these little folds here, and just with these simple folds, you'll be amazed at how much strength and rigidity you can get out of this system. So now you can see we've got this structure. Even when we put the weight on, we can see it's barely moved at all. Add a little bit more weight. See, now we're getting a little bit of movement in the structure and distortion. So you can see the true power of having such arch structures. And Mola actually has a special deal for anyone that can pick it up in the short period of time that we have the Kickstarter going. Pick up any of the kits at a significant discount. Even this Mola Kit. I think it's beneficial to anyone that actually loves structural mechanics, even teaching it. And if you just click the link in the below description, I get a small affiliate kickback, but you also get an amazing discount during this Kickstarter campaign. And if you did like this video, there's a number of couple of videos here about the different Mola videos that I've done in the past. They're really quite interesting, especially when you're trying to teach other people about the structural mechanics. And if you're interested in supporting the channel, there's two ways that you can do this. You either can become a YouTube or Patreon member. Without the support of my YouTube and Patreon members, this type of content would not be possible. And as always, keep learning, and I hope to see you next week. Bye.